shareholders, it gives me a great pleasure to extend a warm and hearty welcome to all of you in the 40th annual general meeting of your company. The financial statements along with director's report have been with you for some time now, and with your permission I shall take them as read.
Yes sir. Okay sir. Fine.
I would like to briefly touch on 3% in 1890. The tax collection figures during financial year 1780 show an increase in net indirect taxes by 18% on year-on-year basis. While the growth in tax collections may be attributed to the growth in economy and rising compliances, it is also as a result of implementation of GST. GST has played a big role in the direct tax collection by putting a check on tax evasion, which in turn has boosted the direct tax revenue collections. The Union Budget for 1890 was announced by Union Finance Minister in the Parliament on February 1st, 2008. This year's budget focuses on
what is your impression about today's AGM?
No, meeting as such is organized well, everything is okay. Yeah. Only thing is our doubt is there as a shareholder. Yeah. After 40 years, our AGM hui hai. So last 1 year mein koi progress ho nahi paayi company ke. So hum logo ka wo concern tha. Ki bhai isme jo profitability honi chahiye thi is company mein. Turnover bhi wahi raha hai jo last year tha. Uske bawajood bhi jo final profit वो बचा वो आधे से भी कम हो गया. अच्छा। तो उसके कारण हम लोगों का डिविडेंड भी कंपनी को कम करना पड़ा. अच्छा। कंपनी का फोकस क्या है कि भाई गवर्नमेंट की तरफ ध्यान देना है. गवर्नमेंट चाहती है कि भाई फार्मर्स की इनकम डबल हो, तो नेचुरली दे विल गिव मोर सब्सिडीज इन द फर्टिलाइजर वेरियस प्रोडक्शन. लेकिन उसमें शेयर होल्डरों को कुछ बेनिफिट हो पाएगा कि नहीं, ये कहना बहुत मुश्किल है. तो इसी वजह से हम लोगों का कंसर्न था दिस टाइम कि भाई हम एजीएम में आके जरा पूछना चाह रहे थे. हमने मैनेजमेंट से क्वेश्चन पूछा भी इस बारे में, लेकिन ऐसा अभी लगता है क्योंकि जो इंटरनेशनल सिनेरियो है, क्योंकि इतना डॉलर का प्राइस बढ़ गया मतलब वो अप्रिशिएट हो गया, साथ में क्रूड का पोर्शन बढ़ा, प्राइस बढ़ा. क्रूड इज ऐसे इम्पोर्टेंट इनपुट इन फर्टिलाइजर ऑल्सो, तो उसकी वजह से भी हमको लगता है फ्यूचर इज नॉट वेरी वेरी ब्राइट. लेकिन इट मे पुल थ्रू इफ द गवर्नमेंट गिव्स मोर सपोर्ट एंड ऑल दैट, बिकॉज़ आफ्टर ऑल इट इज अ पीएसयू कंपनी.
मिस्टर धात्रक, विल यू काइंडली लेट अस नो अबाउट रिवाइवल ऑफ सम प्रोजेक्ट्स?
वी आर इन्वॉल्वड इन रिवाइवल ऑफ कल्चर प्रोजेक्ट एंड बीवीएफसीएल. बीवीएफसीएल प्लांट इज ऑलरेडी रनिंग, बट दोज टू प्लांट्स नामरू 3 एंड नामरू 4 are running with less efficiency. Government is planning to construct one more new plant of 1.27 million ton per annum of urea capacity, and once this plant is started, the inefficient plant will be stopped. This is in case of BVFCL Namru.
How about Gorakhpur and Sindri?
Gorakhpur Sindri HURL is revival. Government has planned to revive these fertilizer units, and the idea is our fertilizer urea production in the country is to the tune of 24 million tons per annum, and our consumption in the country is about 30 million. So there is a gap of 6 million. We want to be self-sufficient, because whenever we are importing, the prices of urea rises, and then we have to buy it for our fertilizer and ensure food security for the country. So to overcome this difficulty, we want to be self-sufficient. That is how these new plants are coming up: Gorakhpur, Sindri, Barauni, Ramagundam, Talcher, and BBFCL. And this one more plant, Matix plant, is already ready, waiting for gas. So with commissioning of all these plants, India will be self-sufficient in case of urea.